Honestly, I tend to forget way up. I am without really trying all that hard. Okay, yes. I'm on Route 7 Tandor Sheets. And I believe we've got a trainer there. Now I've been working on Motoya, making sure they're a little more on par with the rest of the crew. But that needs to come to an end, because Motoya has some pretty bad typing for this area. Ground flying. It's mostly the ground part, and going up against numerous things, which, seem to use a lot of water. Which is really freaking bad against something that's ground flying. Oh god, that guy was talking in Leet. Cedric. Brand. Can't tell too much at a glance on its typing. I mean, I have suspicions to your, the faster and you've got bite with flinch chance. Well, let's try 58. Ah! Okay, there's no way this can keep up. Of course it misses. Okay, I've got one more safe bite before I have to heal for sure. Medicine. Super potion on poise. Just get poise way back up there quick. Okay, 13 points of damage. Faster than me. This is really freaking annoying. Because, that flinch chance. Is it Serene Grace? It plainly seems to just have the devil's own luck, as many would say, when it comes to its attacks. So I'ma just keep attacking. Even with the crazy flinch chance I seem to be taking on. That herb probably because I haven't really used it. Though bite's actually a fairly common attack. Yeah, this Pokemon had to have something augmenting it. Yeah, Balunge. Forget what that one is. Let's bring in Flashy Cat. Why was it only using Bite? If it was only using Bite... Huh. Feel like there's a thing going on there. That'll hit me from neutral. I'm hitting... Oh, wow. I'm hitting you a lot harder than you're hitting me. Although you did hit me for 11 points of damage there. That was pretty good. Huh. Nope. Alright, youngster Cedric registered. The team took a pretty good beating in the first 5 minutes. Holy crap. Kinda impressed, honestly. Most of the time it takes longer for now a third of the team to actually be notably damaged. I seem to be going ahead of the curve. Ooh, there's a thing. Ooh, a Firestone. That does open up one of my favorite Eevee evolutions. I just gotta find an Eevee. And from there on, I only have that one Eevee, and there are a lot of freaking options. So many options. What am I supposed to do? Well, just a random encounter, and right now, I'm willing to bet the best thing I can do. Is just keep attacking. Because I can't really think what else to do right now. Well, now I just want to run through things. You're what, bug grass? Even by your design? Yeah, that's not gonna do much, not gonna lie. Smog. Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna just keep attacking. Just keep attacking with smog. And it's gonna keep trying to sap me. But the poison. Yeah. Poison ought to take its toll eventually. Yes, poison's level 21. What? Ooh, poison fang. Yes. Poison fang is a physical. Equal power to tackle. I'll keep you around for that. May also poison. Yeah, smog. Smog can get switched for poison fang. That's, I'm pretty sure poison has a better physical than special. Yeah, 31 compared to 24. I have. Also got a Matoya up to level 20, because, oh boy, they needed that. Now, yeah, I've done my research and reminded myself for Matoya to evolve. I need the Razor Fang, a hold item. Just needs to hold that item and evolve. That's it. Of course, I need to find the item. And right now, I have no idea where that item is. But, yeah. That's kinda. Yeah. Well, still, I'm playing a new Pokemon game to me, so. Oh! Thanks, Kokoran. Yeah, you just boosted your attack. Oh, did boost defense too. Oh, wait. Boosted attack and defense at the cost of speed. I remember my stuff right. I'll take my chance with poise. Yes! Ooh, badly poisoned even. Alright. 22. See, the badly poisoned indicator is very helpful to me. Because that means that Kokoran is going to be taking an increasing amount of damage each turn. Now, badly poisoned is the status inflicted by toxic. Yeah, I gotta deal with sand tomb on poise. But things are looking good for a win here. Alright. Kokoran went down, poise stands ready, and yes, I'm going to change my Pokemon against the Brainlip. Bring in Bon. Bonsav. Well, honestly, I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right, gonna be honest, because I sort of just put things together, and I am presuming that I did it right. So, if there are any French speakers, and I've been making you cry with that, let me know. As I would like to pronounce it a little more correctly. Not completely correctly, maybe. Because me seeing the letters, there really is no guarantee I'm gonna get it right. Though still, you can't actually throw a phonetic guide at me and I'll be able to understand the crap I'm doing. A little rusty, because it's been quite a while since I did study linguistics, but it's in there. Alright, come on. It's not very effective, but oh man, is it doing good damage. And seriously, the tune keeps looping. But it'd take a while in a fight. Probably don't notice it. Yeah, it doesn't have a chance to do that when I'm grinding, just because battles are short. Alright, Bubble Beam for the win. Good job, Bon. Good job. There's Mamet. Huh. Okay, yeah. My team's hurting a bit. So I am pulling a very quick retreat. Headed back to the heel house. Ah, Grozard. You're adorable. Prepare to die. Let's see. Bulldoze. Ground type attack, though I've got the level advantage. I had to worry because ground is super effective against poison. Okay. Still haven't really figured it out. I suspect it's a grass one. Which is actually pretty helpful. Because that means poison can actually go in against a ground type and have something to use, opposed to just kind of spinning their wheels. Alrighty, let's talk with the lady. You're my Pokemon. Okay. One way, I get the feeling you're a trainer. Well, I was right. Cool trainer Joss. Corsola. Huh. Oh, wait a sec. Corsola. You're water rock. And if hidden power is in fact grass, it is going to wreck you. Yeah. Alright, that's a rock type attack, which has a chance to do absurd things to the Corsola stats. In terms of boost them, and yeah. Yeah, I think that course that poises hidden power is indeed grass. Couldn't tell you anything else about it. Just cause yeah, it's a two-part formula. See, one portion of the formula determines the type. The other portion of the formula actually determines the power. Yeah, maybe I should just take the time. Pardon? Find the math and do the math. because unlike most Pokemon games, I have the numbers directly available to me. It is amazing. Come on. Well, I got the win here. Alrighty. Not gonna... Laffy. Yes. Yes, you are going to get changed. Matoya is a much better choice against you. Going to your typing. That was getting my stuff turned around. Ah, that's annoying. Yeah, we'll admit, while I'm dealing with this, I'm taking some time and calling up the formula I was just talking about. Ah, hidden power. Here it is. Calculation. It really is math. It's nothing hard. Stuff I can do in like 30 seconds. The thing is, well, I need the formula, as it has been quite a while since I've even tried to do this math. And if I want to figure it out, ah, here we go. Mathematically, this is the equivalent of... Wow. Ah. Okay. Well, actually, let's double check. Power. Alright, Matoya's got this. Huh. Alright, that's interesting. Was just calling up the formula looking specifically at this game, Uranium. Because it's important to make sure that you're using the proper formula. Let's see, depending on the Pokemon used. Here we go. It's a random encounter. I don't have to fight it. Okay. The simplest way to calculate IVs is by matching up their IVs in the following chart. O stands for any odd number, E stands for any even number, and X stands for any number. Okay. Wow. So, for me to learn exactly what, let's see, even, odd, even, odd. So, what I expect, let's see, grass is any, even, odd. Oh, that doesn't... Oh, nope. I was forgetting about HP. It includes HP, which is any, even, odd. And that's any, even, odd. Yeah, unless... Ah, the raw formula to determine HP type. Well, oh. Wow. Okay, time for a little bit of math. And you know what? Because I'm talking about it, I'm actually going to talk my way through this. So, hidden power type. Ah, the raw formula to determine a hidden power works as follows. So, oh, that's actually something else in my notebook. So, HP equals... Alright, now I'm going... HP meaning hidden power type equals HP plus 2 times attack plus 4 times defense plus 8 times special attack plus 16 times, wow, this is a lot longer than I remember it. Special attack, right? Special defense plus 32 times speed. All that multiplied by 16 divided by 63. All right. So, for those of you following along at home, that means HP IV of 8 plus 2. That's 10. Times 4, which is 10, times, let's see, oh, rather than inputting the IV value directly, the variable inserted is 1 if the IV, oh, okay, rather than that, there was a little more to it. This is why you read the whole thing before you start doing math. So, if the stat is... No, if the IV of the stat is odd, it is a 1. So that's 1 plus 2 times the attack, which is even, is 0 plus 4 times defense, which is 10, so another 0 plus 8 times special attack, which is another 8, which means even, so 0. Special attack plus 16 times special defense, which is even. Oh, no. I'm saying the wrong thing. Thankfully, I'm writing down the right thing. Special defense, which is odd. So that is a 1 plus... what was it? 32 times speed, which is odd, so 0. Oh, wow. I need to remember something I haven't thought about in freaking ages. It makes a huge freaking difference when I'm doing this. Alright, parentheses, exponents, multiplication. There aren't any exponents, so we just move on to the multiplication. So, minus 1 plus 0 plus 4 times 0 is 0. Plus another 0. Plus 16 times 1 is 16. Plus 32 times 0, which is 0. Okay. Well, I'm still working within the parentheses, so I need to, like, actually go through things properly. Next is addition, which gives me all of 17 times 16. Alright, what is that? 17 times 16 equals that divided by 63 to get 4.31746. I took it out farther than I needed to, let me tell ya. Come on. Flick. Alright, close that. Alright. Yeah, but I know that's wrong. Going up, that isn't what I was trying to figure out. Wanted to freaking... The raw fuel moon power works as follows. Okay. So, I did some math wrong there. Because I haven't done math in a little while. Well, complicated math like that. And yes, that counts as complicated because I had parentheses, addition, and subtraction going along with the multiplication, and order of operations mattered a lot in order to make sure I did everything right. Plus, as I recollect, if that would have been super effective there, but I've long since freaking did. So, my erroneous math. If you go from the final results I was talking about, said, 4 odd. Oh, wait, no. Again, I realize I didn't do everything I was supposed to. The outcome is rounded down to the nearest whole number. So, that was supposed to be 12. The end result of that was supposed to be 12. Well, around 12. So, I screwed up something pretty good. Let's see here. This way to calculate. Alright, so as far as I know, So, I managed to click something so wrong, I stopped part of my recording. There's going to be a discrepancy between things, and I know it. Well. Okay, back to the fight. And yeah, I need to freaking. Yeah, I want to determine the exact. Yeah, I do want to determine the exact IV and power. Well. And power, calculator, Cypok tools. No, oh, hey, boys leveled up. So, on that note, since I'm actually working with a freaking calculator, so all I have to do is punch my numbers into this handy dandy. Yeah, defense IV is 10. Special attack is 8. Special defense is 7. And speed, the final stat, is 1. Alright, this is using Cypok's calculator. Okay, I think. Yeah, I think I've got the answer I wanted. I didn't quite get the number I was expecting, I'll admit that. When I was reviewing the math there, things weren't adding up properly. The type was wrong. And, because I've long since figured out the type. Though, I'm decently sure that I can count on a different part of the formula to yield the power. Oh crap. Hold on, poise! This might be end of poise, ladies and gentlemen. Oh dear god, it is. Oh dear god, there goes poise. Wow, that just wrecked them hard. Matoya doesn't have to worry about that, simply because of its flying type. Sand Veil. Fury Cutter would be the best thing you've got going there, but let's say Toucan. Let's see, the Pumpkin, no. Flashy can. Well, Flashing Cannon encounters the same problem. Wow. Yeah, Bon. Bon, I need ya! I need ya to save me! Magnitude 6. That's gonna hurt Bon. But it can't. I don't think it's gonna kill him. Oh. Wow. Bon straight up resisted that. Alright, so you're bringing the Endure to the table. Trying to get as much damage in on me as you can before you go down, huh? Is that Scratch? That's not gonna do much. Well. Okay, plus side, well, don't have to worry about Bon and figuring out his, her power anymore. They're dead. Dead as a doornail. Well, that's a thing. And yeah, well, let's patch up the rest of the crew. There's only one way this can end. The list of the dead grows. Well, that means Flash is coming into the party. Boys, it's been fun, but it is time to say goodbye. They're dead. Goodbye. Sashay away. Well, yes, continue box operations, move into the party. One Kasnail. Now, there's only one other thing to do. Run the save protocol. Ladies and gentlemen, it's been fun, but I'm out of time to do this. I will see everyone next time for more Pokemon Uranium Nuzlocke goodness. Been a while since we had a death. Dang.